Hello and welcome! My name is Victor Frescura from Danfoss Climate Solutions, and in this video we are going to take a closer look on how to start with MCX design.
During this training we'll develop the control of the water level inside the water tank. The idea is the one to open a water valve when the water level gets the low level and to close the water valve when the water goes back to the high level. The MCX will read two digital inputs and will act on digital output for opening or closing the water valve. So now we can go for the practice. Double click over the MCX design icon. When the tool is ready, we start saving a new project from the menu File, New. Here we can select the type of display between LCD display or LED display, or we can select to develop a library. In this case we are going to develop an application, so we select LCD display because the MCX we are going to use mounted LCD display type. We fill in the project name with water level control. We define where save the project, and after pushing create a new project, we are ready to start the software. The MCX design propones a starting template with a small example for every tabs. We are going to use the MCX06D, so we can delete the MCX06 1V proposed inside the electric wiring tab. Now, from Components tab, MCX board, we pick up the MCX06D and we drop it inside the electric wiring. In case your application requires an I/O expansion board, you must just move a little bit down and inside the MCX expansion group select the one you are interested in. In this case, the I/O expansion board is not required, so we keep only the main board. And now we can start to build the electric wiring. First of all, the MCX inputs must be set properly in order to read correctly what we are going to connect. In this case, the application requires two digital inputs. We'll use the one with polarity normally closed. This type of bricks must be connected with the MCX from the end with the green label. In the other side we connect the virtual function, that is the variable that connects the logic with the electric wiring and vice versa. From the resources tab, virtual function, in this case digital input, we add in the variable with right click at virtual function and filling in all the fields. Pay attention to follow the rules in the left part of the windows, and also pay attention that label and variable name must be typed without space. In our application we have high water level from the digital input 1. After entering the name and confirming with the button OK, you'll find the new variable inside the digital input 3. Now we can drag, drop it and connect with the brick DI and C. We do the same for the low tank water level, adding the new virtual function connecting with the digital input 2 of the MCX, preset as normally closed input. All the bricks hold help with a brief introduction, the explanation of the inputs, the explanation of the outputs, and when required, an example. This is very useful for understanding how to use the brick. For getting the help, is enough. Select the brick and push the F1 button. For complete the wiring, we add the water valve as digital output 1. So, from Resources tab, right click over the virtual function Digital Output, we fill in all the fields and push the OK button. We drag and drop the virtual function into the electric wiring. We drag and drop the brick DO and O from the Components tab for setting the MCX Digital Output 1. We connect them and the wiring is completed. If during the wiring the information reported inside the MCX picture are not enough for understanding the inputs and outputs type, it's possible open the MCX datasheet right away from the electric wiring, like as we did for the help of the brick. So just selecting MCX brick and pushing F1 button. Completed the wiring, if we move inside the logic tab, the three variables we added will be available for developing the logic part. Before starting with the logic part, we suggest to compile the software in order to check if there are any issues.
Thank you for watching. For more information, please contact your local Danfoss support or visit our website, danfoss.com. Bye bye.